this roadshow to find out about the people's concerns. I did this roadshow because I wanted the people to be able to meet me in person. I wanted to show them that I'm not here to hide from them and take their votes, but I'm here to let them see the kind of person that I am. And if I'm who they like, and if I'm who they love and they embrace, I am embracing them already.
Great. So, right now through election, general elections,
definitely you should expect a developmental agenda from me. That most people call it a manifesto. And although all of these are never manifested, they are very much interested that our policies will be implemented. So a manifesto will not become a diary in our governmental books. I am here because I believe that a change can happen with the strength of the youth. The youth are powerful, they have strength, they have degrees, they have educational background, but their voices are not being heard. And even their chances to be a part of democracy, they're being taken for granted. As you all know, they only gave them 20 days to try and be a part of democracy. It's going to take another 4 years for another 18-year-old person before they get an opportunity to vote. By that time, these people will be out of the country. What we're doing is that we are exporting our talent out. We are driving them out. I want to educate them about democracy. I want them to understand about their democratic rights, how that their thumb determines their future and what they have to do based on government. I know that it's difficult times now, but I know that very soon the youth that are coming are going to understand the value of democracy. And this is why we're doing this roadshow. It's all part of the education. It's all part of the encouragement. It's all part of the reason why I want Ghanaians to understand that, look at the youth. It's a lot of us. There are way too many of us. Our voices need to be heard. Our chances, our rights need to be taken serious. Do not take us for granted. Let us through the door. We are here to work. We are here to change the country. We are here to build the country. We are here to stop our fathers from the mistakes that they did that have landed us in this situation. And I know I'm not going to do it alone. I'm going to do it with the rest of the nation.
What are some of the things that...
Look, I just came from Ashiama, and I've just met the worst road ever in Ghana. And I'm wondering, when I went to Ashiama, I can see that there are more than 200,000 people there. They should not have this road. They should have an economy, just like Manchester or Liverpool or anywhere in Dubai. When you go there, the area, the region, the kind of jobs that is coming from the region, it's only right that the roads have to be done. The railways have to be done. The lifestyle that the people needed, the malls and the hospital. Until we add value to the regions and the people of this country, we cannot build our roads. We cannot build the hospitals. Even if we build the hospitals, how are they going to pay when they have no jobs? And that's what we're bringing. We're bringing the 16th Industrial Revolution. And we are changing the 16th Regional Industrial Revolution because we want to use our resources, both human resources and mineral resources. We don't want to sell it anymore to go to the outsiders. We want to manufacture it ourselves. We want to be able to refine it ourselves. We want to be able to learn about our cocoa seed, our gold, our everything in this country. We want to learn about it, and we want to give ourselves jobs. It's a new beginning. Freedom is here.
Mommy, young boys are coming here.